Welcome back to the channel. Today it's so freaking exciting. We are going up the Great Wall of China. We are going up the Great Wall of China.
I never thought we'd be doing this.
If you had told 16-year-old David that in 10 years' time he'd be married and going up the Great Wall of China, I would not have believed you. But we're going to show you all of it. We're going to toboggan down. We're going to take a cable car up. We're doing both sides of it. It's going to take about 4 hours. And we're very, very excited. So come with us. The next stop is a shuttle bus from this tourist place up the mountain. For those of you who don't know, the Great Wall of China is one of the seven wonders of the world. The wall is over 21,000 kilometers long, and it's going to be sweet.
We're going to do the east route and the west route. You can pick one or the other, but we decided to do both because we're adventurous sometimes. And so we're going to take a shuttle bus and then a cable car up. We're going to toboggan down the east side and then another cable car up the west side, which goes the tallest tower of the Great Wall of China. And then we're going to take a cable car down.
Step one is the shuttle bus. Hey, we made it through the entrance. We're going up to the cable car to go to the Great Wall of China. So here's the toboggan track we're gonna go down in a little bit. We're currently making our way up the Great Wall of China.
I think I'm scared of heights. This is scary.
What do you think?
This is super cool. Woo-hoo.
This is what it's like to walk on the Great Wall of China. The steps are super steep and there's lots of people, but not as many as we thought. So it's super fun and interesting and cool.
And it's hot.
It's always hot. This is super steep. All right, we came down this side and now we are gonna go toboggan down and then get the gondola up to the other side to try and go to the highest viewpoint, but it's very hot and we have to be back down for lunch at 2:30. Okay, so that's what it looks like. There's your brake, and we're gonna switch to the 360 camera now.
you.
I'm holding on, if almost gone. Someday I know I'll finally make it through the gates, just have to wait. You whisper to me.
David's a little bit of a daredevil though. He was going so fast down that.
If there weren't people in front of me and if I wasn't making sure Shay was behind me, I definitely would have flown off the edge of it. It was so much fun though. That's one of the options you can do when you come here, or you can just walk down, but this is way faster and we want to go up the second part of the wall. So come with us now.
Second cable car ride.
When you come here and you come on a tour, your entrance, everything here is your passport. So our tour guide on the bus ride here was an hour and a half registered. So we can get into the lower section, this section, and everything else except for the luge ride. So it's pretty efficient. They just scan your passport and you're good to go.
If you do come to the Great Wall of China, it's a ton of walking. We're only halfway down the day and my watch says I've climbed 30 flights of stairs already, which is like almost 6,000 steps. So be prepared to do a lot of walking. Even though the cable cars do take you up and down, you are still walking a ton. I love to walk so much.
Yes.
Got yes. One to ourselves.
So
we just have to climb a whole bunch of stairs just to get to the cable car.
To climb more stairs on the Great Wall, but yeah. We're not complaining. So far with all the traveling, I'd say the Great Wall is the one thing where I'm still amazed on the entire thing, even though it's hot and there's lots of people, but not as many as expected. It's just so impressive that they built it all the way up on these mountains. Heading back down. This is by far the coolest thing we've done on our 4 months of traveling.
It's our first wonder of the world.
Six to go. And if you want to know how to book this tour, I'll link it in the description. We highly recommend it. Okay, we just made it back to Beijing city center and we're going to take the subway back to our hotel. They have full airport security. Your bags have to go through a scanner and we have to talk to the front desk lady to get our tickets.
Okay.
made it out of the subway, and then we have a 10-minute walk back to our hotel. Thanks so much for watching our videos. By the time you're watching this, we are probably in the Philippines because there's not the best Wi-Fi in our hotel, and we're only in China for 5 days. But we can't wait to share more of this cool, beautiful country we're exploring. So we'll see you next time.